members of the Salesian family, ladies and gentlemen. I feel very happy to be present at Don Bosco's birth bicentenary celebrations. I am thankful to you for having invited me at this function. Remembering great men who have served the humanity in various ways is the pious duty of every human being. The world has seen innumerable men who have given unto it virtuous knowledge and message for service of the mankind. Many have faded from the memory despite their valuable contribution. But the outstanding amongst such people, be they religious priests, rulers, social reformers, leaders, etc., still survive in the memory lane for serving the human cause. Saint Don Bosco is one such person who is being and will always be remembered for all that he has done for the uplift of the society, its betterment, its spread of education, service to the poor and unprovided, and love for all human beings. Poverty and odds at home during childhood and young age are generally regarded as a curse, but to John Bosco, these became an inspiration and instruments of experience that persuaded him to go ahead with higher studies and acquire skillful knowledge. Difficulties faced by him were set off by the encouragement which he received from his mother, and he became a priest in June 1841. Illiteracy and development of the society cannot go together. Don Bosco realized this fact and dedicated himself to provide holistic education to the poor and abandoned youngsters. He had a compassionate heart and was moved by the maltreatment and repressive of the juvenile prisoners in jails. He couldn't bear violence against these prisoners. He thought of and introduced preventive system of education, a system based entirely on reason, religion, and above all, loving kindness, which excluded all violent punishment. It was a comprehensive concept of education that entailed total development of a person. He laid focus on the role of an educator to discover the goodness in every youngster and persuade him to be a part of the growth-enhancing process for honest citizenship. He believed in positive education. Today, the world is witnessing a curious phenomenon. The youngsters are becoming individualistic and materialistic. Moral values are relatively of less value to them. Their emotional life is under alteration. The diversity of youth culture is to be clearly understood, and so also their tendencies, ambitions, and surroundings. All these have made significant changes in their approach to life. Disruptions in families, lack of togetherness and brotherhood, the pressure of wants, etc., have seriously affected their approach. They are at crossroads. Unemployment is haunting them. Social pollution is gradually leading them to restlessness and intolerance. Their faith in God has diminished. But still, there is another class of young people who are opting for social change, civic participation, caring for ecology, art, culture, sport, volunteering to work with the poor, and many creative ways of helping the society in which they live. Their knowledge and communication skills have grown manifold. Their network has widened. Though they want to bring about a healthy society, yet their efforts are riddled with insurmountable obstacles. We cannot go with a stereotyped pattern of youth work to make a difference in the life of the young. The followers of Don Bosco impart integral value-based education to the youth of India in various contexts, academic, technical, and in unorganized sectors. Though the world claims to be more advanced and civilized, there are still a large number of poor, abandoned, disabled, and destitute young men who need attention and opportunities. The Salesian family, founded by Don Bosco, consisting of priests, brothers, and sisters, as well as cooperators, benefactors, and past peoples, continues to spread his work throughout the world. The family truly shares with him his prediction for the young. The one principle that guides them still is the same principle that guided Don Bosco. I quote, "That you are young is enough to make me love you very much," unquote. Today, on this historical day, when we welcome the bicentenary of the birth of this great educator and friend of youth, Don Bosco, it is fitting that a congress is held in his honor. The vast gathering of the members of the family he founded and inspired is a manifestation of the authenticity and relevance of his mission in our times. I am told that the Salesians came over to India more than 100 years ago. Today, they have more than 1,000 institutions with a dedicated workforce of about 6,500 men and women consecrated to the cause of the poor youth. This passion has taken the form of schools, colleges, orphanages, hostels, and homes for the young people at risk, such as street children, migrant youth, child laborers, and bonded youth. There are several kinds of social work undertaken by the followers of Don Bosco. My ardent wish is that those who know Don Bosco and are members of the Salesian family also become passionate about the cause of the young people in our country. We need to create a civilization of love, vast networks for good, platforms for the reform of our cultures and mindsets, think tanks to plan strategies and task forces to take upon issues at various levels. The Don Bosco family members should be ever ready to join hands with anyone, just so that the young people of the nation could have a brighter future. With these words, I congratulate you for holding this function, and I end my speech and thank you again for inviting me to this function. Jai Bharat.